show you the materials I use for moulding up silicone moulds. As you can see, we've got a couple of moulds here. Here's a poured mould, which you can see is being poured into a cube shape. And inside this mould is a small gargoyle, which I've casted up in resin, and they've been featured on some of the videos already. So there's that one. That's just pouring in the silicone. And also moulds which have been featured is this silicone mould, which was a brush-on silicone mould. So there's two techniques there. I won't go so much into the techniques, but I'll show you which type of silicone I use. So this is a 1.1 kilogram container, and this is the main silicone, and then you've got the catalyst, and I've got a red catalyst here. And to make these simple pour molds, you just need these two items, mix them together, and just pour into your mold shape. And like I say, you need the additive thickener to make the brush-on molds here, which of course is the fish silicone mold. So anyway, starting off, I'll just read what we've got on the container here. This is Polycraft GP3481F silicone rubber. So this is high strength silicone mold making rubber, specially formulated for easy mixing by hand with color coded components, giving a visual aid to ensure adequate mixing. The two components mix easily and is widely used without a vacuum chamber. This silicone is suited for the detailed reproduction of figures, art objects and similar items, and ideal for use with a wide range of resins and casting materials. So yeah, I use this also, this particular silicone, as you don't need a vacuum chamber as stated in the instructions here. So if you're mixing by hand, you don't have to worry so much about trapped air in your silicone. So we'll continue on here. Mix ratio by weight, 10 base, which is this, with one catalyst, which is this. Mix well before use. For best results, ensure materials are at temperature above 20 degrees Celsius before using. Using at cold temperatures will affect cured characteristics and may inhibit cure. Ensure molds are free from dust and other contaminants. Always perform small tests before pouring large amounts to ensure suitability. Keep containers closed when not in use. When stored correctly, an open product has a shelf life of 6 months from purchase. Please refer to website for further information regarding usage. So there's some safety information on here, and you can obviously read that when you order this stuff. So under the catalyst here, I use the red stuff. There's different colours of catalyst just to indicate the type of catalyst it is. I use this catalyst, this red catalyst, because it gives me ample working time while I'm making the moulds, making my moulds. So the information on this catalyst is pretty much the same information that we've got on the side of the base. Other than, oh, we've got some more information here. Curing times at 25 degrees C, 6 to 8 hours. Working time, 40 to 60 minutes. Demold time, 12 to 24 hours. I usually wait a whole 24 hours before demolding. The cured colour is pink, so that's pretty obvious, with red mixed with the base of white, and it gives you that pink colour. So if you're going to make a brush-on mould, like I said earlier, you'll want to mix in some of this silicone thickener. So I'll do the same again and read what's on here. So again, this is like Polycraft make. Polycraft Dow Corning Silicone Thick So. Thixotropic agent is an additive for RTV silicon to thicken the silicone. The liquid silicone is thickened to make it more suitable to creating certain types of molds. With the correct amounts of agent, the silicon may be smoothed onto the original. For those of you that prefer to use a brush up technique when making molds, for best results, we could always recommend applying a first coat of unthickened silicon to create a bubble free mold. That's what I do. I usually put a couple of coats of just these two components and then mix up further layers with this thickener until you get it to the thickness that you want with the layers of silicon on the mold. Silicon Thixo may harden and become firm in low temperatures. Stand container in a hot water bath to restore to liquid form. Mix ratio is add 25 grams per kilo of silicon, so you can obviously work out the quantity you need with whatever quantities you're using of the silicon and catalyst. So there we are, that's about it. I'll be using this silicon to make up a mold of the clay fairy door, which I put a video up, the last video that I put up. So I'll make a video of making the mold for that fairy door, and that'll go up very soon, this week sometime. And then once we made the mold, we'll make some casts of the fairy door out of various items, concrete, resin, and maybe other materials. So anyway, I hope that helped, and there we are. So thanks for watching, and over and out for now. Right, so here we are today, and I'm going to show you which materials. So, got some technical information here, which some of it I know and some of it I haven't got a clue what it is, but I'll be there anyway. So properties. Polymerization. That's a bit of a mouthful. Tensile strength MPA 3.0, whatever that means. Remove contact lenses if present and easy to do.